Hey guys, Dan here, and contrary to popular belief, I'm actually not dead. I'm still alive, I still work, and a full-time job, and I still own the rights to the Gamer Shelter and everything. I'm actually still the one behind everything. You know, and obviously Dave too, but I'm not dead. Even though videos don't come out ever. That's not what this video is about. So I'm going to be introducing my friend Lee here, who you guys have seen recently. You know him by Rekimaru in the Smite games and such. But I'm going to be kind of introducing him because he's going to be carrying some videos coming pretty soon. He's going to be uploading videos that I'm not in, which is weird. You guys probably will hate all of them. But
yeah, I hate them because they're so good.
Exactly. Just, wow, I hate perfectness.
I know, right?
But, so anyway, I want to introduce Lee since he's going to be carrying some videos by himself. So, Lee,
hey guys.
Yourself. How are you?
My name's Lee, as Dan
I didn't
has
say that 10 times.
told us already. My in-game name is Rekimaru, as you see, and I have been in a couple of videos with Dan as well.
It's also R3KK1M4RU.
Yeah, for all you super awesome people out there who understand.
So Lee, what kind of gamer are you? Would you say what kind of games do you like?
Well, I personally like the games where I win.
Those are good.
Those are my personal favorite. But I'm also a big fan of I like strategy. You know, I like a lot of role playing RPG stuff. I do MOBAs right now a lot. Dungeon Crawler, so things of that nature. I mean, I do first persons on occasion, but
yeah. Basically, the thing that I really like about Lee, other than the fact that I rob him of his money all the time,
and I'm damn sexy,
he does not put up a fight about it. But the thing I like about Lee is our gaming styles are just very different. I'm very into the hardcore, just the shooting and the explosions and stuff, and then he's like the strategy guy that comes in. He's like, "No, guys, I think we should go left lane," you know. And except he sounds a little nerdier than that.
Yeah. But you know, someone's got to be the brains of the operation.
Yes,
you know?
It's true. It's true. That's why I'm here. But so anyway, I just wanted to introduce him a little bit. And Lee, what is this? I've never had this game on my channel before.
This is actually this is a newer game that's out. It actually came out I would have to say at least a couple of months ago. But it's called Heroes of the Storm. It's kind of the Blizzard Entertainment's take on MOBA, and so far it's really cool. Basically, it's based off of all the characters are heroes from the Blizzard universe. So you get heroes from the Diablo universe, you get heroes from Warcraft universe, and also the StarCraft universe. So it's really neat.
It's actually really cool. I saw the cinematic trailers and everything, because full disclosure right here, World of Warcraft is a terrible game.
Yeah, I'm not a fan.
Diablo, I've never played. The Warcraft games, like the older Warcraft games, I've played, but I don't remember. And what else is in here?
StarCraft,
which I've only played for like 10 minutes. So I don't fucking fuck Blizzard, I guess is pretty much what I'm saying. Sorry, guys, but evidently I've been too preoccupied with my extremely busy life to play any of your games ever. But this idea is really cool to combine all these universes and to make this one coherent, just this battle with all these different people. It's a really cool idea. Now, you know, once again, I'm not big in this type of game, MOBA. You know, when I started uploading Smite, that was a really big change for me because that's not my kind of game. I play Smite for fun. It's recreational for me. I just like, oh, I'm gonna be Thor and I'm gonna throw my hammer through people's faces. Like that's
I don't
how
know
I
what
it.
Fun is.
Exactly.
Apparently, you can do something like that in games. I don't know.
Yeah,
it's weird.
I'm too busy trying over here.
But I may be a tryhard. Who knows?
Who knows? Just watch the Smite videos, fucking Zebalanka. But so this game though is pretty cool, and I thought now this would be a good game to introduce Leon because it's something that's more fitted to him and that he can talk about, and it's something he cares about, you know. And so I just thought it would be a fitting little introduction to Lee. So Lee, how do you like the game?
Great. I'm sure right now you're kind of looking at a lot of the gameplay. You're kind of figuring out what's going on. But I'm actually playing a character named Vala. She's actually from the Diablo 3 universe. She is the demon hunter there. She's what you would call basically a ranged assassin in this game. So she throws out a lot of firepower. She has a little bit of burst. What I like about her though is she has a lot of utility in her kit. She deals a lot of damage. You know, she has good sustain in lane, and she has a great escape. So if things get in trouble, you know, you can either chase with it or you can get out of dodge, and you'll actually kind of start to kind of see me use it in both cases this game. So that's really cool. Now, the map we're in, it's a kind of a newer map that they brought in with the new update a while back. Basically, as you notice, there's... Oh, glitch. Anyways.
That's built into the game, I'm sure.
Yeah, totally built into the game. Yeah, totally not internet
that's
connection.
The stasis grenade.
Exactly.
That just went off.
As you can see, the objective of this map is basically it's very similar to most MOBAs. You basically they have a core or a base, and the objective is to destroy the other team's base. Now, the cool thing that Blizzard does with this MOBA is they have a couple twists. First of all, in most MOBAs, you have basically a player experience or a player level. And you basically, you know, you farm your lanes for your own levels. Well, in Heroes of the Storm, you actually, it's all in your team. So you have a team experience level. So you really have to work with your team to, you know, really level up the team as a whole. So that's really neat. And just, you know, moving on and everything, you know, right now, one of the cool objectives is there's multiple maps. And for this one, you know, you basically grab these gems by killing other enemies or killing the spider creatures that which you keep seeing. And they drop these gems and you turn them in and you can summon a big spider army for you to help out. Like
good timing.
Good timing, right, right there is one. So it's really cool, you know, and everything, and you know, and you just basically take down towers and everything, and you go to the other base. The person I'm playing as right now is, hold on, gotta kill a bitch.
Oh, you spoke too early.
Too early.
Too soon.
Oh,
oh man.
Wait for it.
That was a bad
wait
call.
For it. Gotta kill a bitch.
There you go.
There we go.
I think maybe redemption.
Anyways, moving on. Yeah, so you just kind of push like any other MOBAs and everything. It's just really cool, and I really kind of like this new take to MOBAs. So, yeah, definitely. I mean, I still think Smite's my favorite MOBA. I'm just saying, but you know, Blizzard's really doing a good job and doing something different.
Yeah, I can definitely see myself playing this game. Now, I've only played one round, you know, and let's just say I did okay.
Hey, you destroyed those bots.
I'm just saying,
they didn't have a chance.
I think it was a clan, and their clan tag just happened to be bot, maybe. I think it's
no. Either that, or the clans were really good at the bottom lane. So they specialized in the bottom lane.
This idea.
And actually, this is what I'm talking about, the turning in. You can actually turn in your gems, and after you turn in so many, you get to summon these big spiders that help you out.
I don't usually play games like this. Like I said, Smite is a rare exception to me because the third person, because of that constant action, you feel like... I mean, Smite feels more like a third-person shooter to me than it does like a MOBA and everything.
No,
it's a very... objective, like third-person shooter and stuff, but that's what I like about it, and I love the reason I say I could see myself playing this game is anyone who watches me play games, you know, I play like Insurgency, Battlefield. I'm an objective player. I don't give a shit about kills. I'm all about the objective, and I love the idea that in this game, everything you do is to help the team. I love that idea. I love that Blizzard is bringing that idea up. You're like, who fucking cares about yourself as long as you're boosting your team up onto that pedestal you need to like keep them up there to win and everything.
No,
I really like that idea.
No, you know, and I completely understand, you know, and like, I mean, granted, in other MOBAs, you know, it's nice to have a player in your team that's, you know, 20-0, you know, but if he's not doing the objectives, then really what's really the point?
Yeah, he's just helping you get, you know, he's helping you out level until the levels wind up you know,
yeah, exactly.
Leveling off, you know, to use a dumb fucking reword. So, I mean, you know, it helps, but it's just, I love the idea of everything helping the team. That's always been a big thing for me, just in general.
Mm-hmm.
So, I didn't even notice your bottom lane.
I am bot, yes. When we first started, I went ahead and typed in to say I was bot lane. One of the great things with... Now, this is actually the very first game of Heroes of the Storm. Yeah, I probably should have said that earlier, but this is actually my very first public game of Heroes of the Storm. Now, before this, I had a couple rounds playing bots, just to kind of get myself in. So I'm doing pretty well, but I've also had a lot of MOBA experience before, so I'm not new to the actual
genre
of MOBA, so that helps me out a lot. But yeah, other than that, I'm sorry, Dan, go ahead.
I was just interested in what you were doing, what your plan was here with you working bot and every single person in the world wanting to kill you.
Yeah, see, but see, that was basically a good example of what I was trying to say. Of Vala has a lot of a nice escape that she can do. It's great because you can earlier on you saw me dash in to finish off the kill. This time I'm dashing out to get the heck out of Dodge.
And there's three bows.
There are three bows and bot too.
And there's a bot. But, that's interesting.
Although I will say now though, the one thing that I think that would make this game incredible is if they hold on.
Gotta get back kill here. This bitch. Wait, you turned around.
Boom.
What was your plan? What were you thinking?
No, but what I will say is that definitely I think if they added like a VGS system that they have in Smite, I think that would really, really make this game a lot better. Just having to constantly type things out when you're in heavy action, it's really hard to do.
Yeah, like there's not even any quick like shortcut keys, huh?
No, I mean you can alt click the map, but that's there's only a certain extent you can. That really helps out.
Yeah, definitely. Like that's definitely one of the most amazing things about Smite. I have horrible memory. If anyone, like, ask Dave. I have horrible, horrible memory when it comes to everything. And when I started playing Smite, I sat down and I studied those fucking VGS. I was just like, I will learn everything. And it's one of the most helpful things ever, especially when you're playing with randoms, to be able to say, on my way, be right back. Just even the basics are just so important. I mean, obviously, telling your team that three people are bottom is slightly more important than some other things that you could possibly say.
Yeah.
Like, hi, you know, but still, so important.
Don't ever go back when you're that low in life to help out. Just don't do what I just did there.
I'm pretty sure you just killed someone who made that same mistake, actually.
Yes.
Yeah, he was like, that guy's gonna kill me. No, I'm gonna kill that guy. No, that guy killed me.
Exactly.
It was the train of thought that happened.
But what my thought process there was, you know, I had my teammates coming in to help. I was trying to do as much damage as I could before I left, but turned out the other players are smart enough to realize that you should probably kill the weakest member of the team.
It was a good idea. Usually I go in and I'm just like, where's that fucking tank? Mm-hmm. Or sometimes I go in and I'm like, where's all the weak people so I can steal every single kill possible? That's sometimes. I switch between those two.
Especially
those two
if he plays Sylvanas.
Uh-huh. Which I see is in this game, by the way.
Yes, but a different type
of
Sylvanas.
But a different Sylvanas. Okay.
Yes,
he's probably just as good at team killing.
This Sylvanas is actually from the Warcraft lore. Now, I'll admittedly... I'm not very knowledgeable about the Warcraft lore. I know Starcraft and Diablo a little bit better, but apparently she's, I guess, a Night Elf or something. But she kind of plays a ranged specialist slash maybe assassin in this game, and that's actually the chick that I was dueling bottom with. So, and she actually just came out recently. So,
Interesting. So how? So this game's in like a semi-closed beta kind of thing right now,
yeah,
is that
yeah,
right?
Yeah, it's actually an open beta
now,
but it's, again, it's semi-open because not everyone can actually get in to play this. You have to have certain requirements for a computer and things of that nature, so...
Okay, so that's cool. So anyone, you know, can try to at least look, if they're interested in this game, how to get into it, and if they can. I think you can buy keys and stuff like that. So that's always cool. How often you've been playing this a little bit? How often have you seen that they've been kind of updating? You said a new character was just added.
Now, granted, I haven't been playing this game for too long, but in the I would say the 2 months I've been playing it, they came up with one major update, and they try to keep up on the smaller updates, things of that nature, on a more weekly, bi-weekly basis.
I mean, it's not really important for me to say, like, for smaller games, it's important to let you guys know, like, oh, how often are they keeping up on this, but this is fucking Blizzard, so you're not gonna have to worry about them skipping out on like certain aspects.
Plus, we all know Blizzard kind of does whatever they want.
That's true. Too. Yeah, maybe they will. I don't know.
You know, whatever.
Next week they're gonna be like, "What's Heroes of the Storm?" I have no idea what you guys are talking about. So,
but anyways, yeah, it's good stuff.
But the video is gonna be coming to a close here pretty soon, so I guess I'm just gonna end it with talking a little bit more about Lee coming to the channel.
Yeah,
he's,
you know,
he's gonna be a pretty big part of the channel coming on here, and I'm really excited. It's someone who can actually record.
I know it took me forever, but now I can.
So he went out of his way to get a computer that could record. So that he didn't really go out of his way, but you know, he made a decision, and so we're gonna be able to start recording multiple views again. My favorite thing to do. So right now, the only game that we have scheduled is still Smite. Mm-hmm. So we can record multiple views in Smite now. We actually have me, him, and Brandon, that you guys know from the Smite video as Random Kill, can also record now.
Yeah,
so we'll
definitely
have three views we can switch between, which will be awesome. I love doing that.
Yeah. So I'm definitely super excited for it.
It's gonna be
hold on, I'm about to kill two bitches here.
Okay, let's just double
kill. And strafe.
Okay. And there you go. Nice little double kill by Vala, okay?
Gotta love her ult.
So, you know, we're trying to see what other games we can do. Lee has been playing a lot. I almost called him Recky. Lee has been playing a lot of Path of Exile lately, and he's been getting me into it, and I like it. I don't know how that would work with recording, so, you know, we'll just be testing some things.
Yeah, definitely.
And, you know, of course, I'm going to get Lee to play Insurgency, because it's the best.
Yeah,
it's
you know, whatever. And we won.
It's so good. Oh, yeah. We won.
The best
There's Lee's classic, "Sorry if I did bad, guys."
No, BD.
BD. Sorry if I did boo.
But yeah, thanks again for watching, and, hope to see you, and check out some of our other videos coming out.
Yep, there'll be more coming. We already have some in the past. There'll be some links, I'm sure. Thank you everyone for watching, and hopefully you guys found Lee at least tolerable during this video. I mean, I do.
I mean, perfection is hard to watch.
Yeah, I have a little bored, and I shift between tolerable and just fucking hatred, and so well, right now it's tolerable, so I was like, make a recording.
Well, but, obviously I'm not doing my job then.
Exactly, get back to fucking terrible. So thank you guys for watching, we hope you enjoyed, and of course, as always, subscribe to see more, guys. We're back, we're coming, okay?
Definitely.
Okay, bye.
Bye.
Give me the panda!